We're here today to chat, aren't we? I've got my daughter here, and we're going to be chatting about this mythical, wonderful ARC notebook from Staples. We're both still Filofax users, aren't we, darling?
Yeah.
Yeah, we're both Filofax users. I've got my Filofaxes here, and here, and here, and you've got your Filofax, which, how long have you had your Filofax?
I've had it for years, but I've only started using it, really, for the past 18 months, 2 years.
Mm. And this is one of the reasons why you're keeping this as a diary, aren't you? Keeping your pocket Filofax as a diary.
Oh, yeah.
But it's just this big problem with...
For me, it's work.
Yes. Work. Well, you've got so many things on at the moment as a student that a pocket Filofax is just too small.
Mm.
And you could go for an A5 Filofax, or you could go for an A4 like your dad's here, but it still might not be big enough or versatile enough or, more importantly, cheap enough, because that is a major consideration, isn't it?
Yeah.
You get a decent Filofax, an A4 Lyndhurst is going to cost you the thick end of £100. Or alternatively, you could get an A4, I spy over there, an A4 ARC notebook in green leather. Mm-hmm. How much did that cost you, darling?
£20, but with discount, student discount, £18.
Okay, so you just flash your student card and you get a discount at Staples, okay?
Mm-hmm.
All right, well, okay, £18. What is the leather like? That's what people want to know, okay? It's the same with Filofaxes. People want to know what the leather's like. It's obviously not calf leather, but...
No, it's nice.
Does it smell good?
It's nice and tactile.
Does it smell like leather?
I guess so.
Okay. So it's got a nice feel to it, and so you reckon you'll be happy with that?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Durable.
Okay. Well, I've got I've obviously got an A4 leather Filofax. But I have the same as you, but just the... Oh, I nearly knocked my coffee over there. Which is one advantage of having just these cheap polypropylene covers, because if you do knock your coffee over, it's not such a disaster, is it? But I'm using an A4 ARC notebook for business meetings. It's like a project book. And I'm also using... an A5 ARC notebook for a similar purpose. So I'm experimenting with A4, A5 in ARC. I've also got my A4 Filofax, which can take pages from my A4 ARC notebook if I hole punch them for the four holes, the standard holes. Which I've demonstrated in another video. So I'm sort of covered, and I've sort of converted you, haven't I, slightly to this ARC thing, and we've been a bit crazy. How much have we spent today on ARC products?
Between us, £60.
Mm. It's watching you two buy stuff in Staples is something.
We love stationery.
You love stationery. Well, I love stationery too. Show me the difference between these rings. You've got these standard discs. I call them rings, but they're actually discs.
I've got the bigger ones.
So these are 1 inch, and those are the you know, I don't know what size these are, but the standard folders in the ARC notebook come with these, and they all come with 60 pages, 60 sheets rather, of paper, which is 100 GSM paper, and you can, it looks like that's a comfortable fit. You could probably get about 80 pages with these standard rings. The 1 inch rings, what's the capacity on those?
It says
150 sheets. Okay, so that's 150 sheets, 300 sides. My opinion is that that's going to be well stuffed. So I would say the capacity is more like 120. But it gives a similar capacity to a standard file effects binder with the 23mm rings. And you can also get the 2-inch discs, but they're just crazy. But that is a good, interesting point to make, that just by changing these discs, you don't have to change anything else, and for the cost of a couple of quid, everything seems to be a £2, doesn't it?
Yeah, I like that. If I was to get a standard notebook, like one of these, for example, once it's full, it's full.
What, one of these?
No, one of these.
Oh, okay. This is just notebook. A pucker pad, isn't it? Okay.
So once it's full. But if I've got one of these, I can just buy new rings and just make a bigger notebook.
Just as a matter of interest, what sort of pens do you use? Because obviously your dad uses fountain pen quite a lot, but...
Mixture, really.
Sort of a mixture of pens. Do you find that one of the things you like is to not have the pen you're using show through?
Oh, yeah, that's really irritating.
Well, look, try my pen. Try my pen and just, if you don't want to waste a sheet of A4, just try that and see what you think. So this is...
here?
Yeah, this is a medium nib. It's just normal blue ink. I can't remember what I'm using, actually. Can't remember. Scrip ink. And, okay, let's have a look at the back. Okay, there's nothing there, is there?
No.
I mean, it is 100 GSM paper, so in fairness to Filofax, one of the advantages of the thinner Filofax paper is you can get more sheets into a given set of rings. So although people decry the fact that Filofax paper isn't necessarily fountain pen friendly, that is actually to your advantage if you want to travel light. So I don't subscribe to, you know, the criticism associated with thinner paper. But it is a joy to use this 100 GSM paper if indeed you use a Filofax. I've got an idea that you'll probably find an advantage with using these ARC binders in lecture theatres. Have you got in your university the stepped seating arrangement in a typical lecture theatre? Have you got that?
Yeah.
Okay. And what is the depth of the what is the depth of the bench in front of you? That you rest your book.
The benches are okay. It's the chairs with the foldy side tables.
So is it an advantage to be able, if you're a student, to be able to completely fold over your, in this case, A5 or maybe A4? You don't have an issue with what we in the Filofax arena call flattability. Or lack of flattability, as the case may be. The fact that you can just fold it over and then just write without that much room being taken as well. Do you see that as a big advantage for students?
Definitely.
Okay. I think we need to talk some more about this, because it's a fascinating subject, isn't it?
So.
Tell me what you're going to do with your actual... pocket Filofax. You're still going to use that. What are you going to use it for?
Oh, this is just going to be my diary still.
Okay,
it goes everywhere with me.
Okay, so is that a day to a page or
a week to two pages?
You must have in there a lot more than. Well, you must have a lot of stuff because that's ridiculously stuffed, isn't it, for a pocket Filofax?
But it's fine.
But it's fine.
It works for me. That's fine.
Good. So that goes in your bag, but these ARC notebooks are going to be used for your projects, lecture notes, that sort of thing.
This one is for uni.
Seeing patients on assignments.
This one is for my volunteering.
That's for your volunteering. Yeah. Okay, so that will go in your bag quite easily.
I mean, they all fit in my bag.
Okay, and then you can. Well, let's talk some more about this. Okay, in a second.